So good morning everyone. Today I'm talking about the OPS in Java. So this paper is balanced to second BSc third semester computer science. Okay. So in previous class I was discussed about what is the history of Java. What is the history of Java? How we use the Java? Okay. Today I'm talking about the variables. So what is variable? So you are available in the C language. So you are available in the C language. The definition is variable is an identifier whose value is changed during the execution of the program. That is called variable. So how it is variable, how it is changing, how it is taking values. Okay. So let me explain what is variable. Okay. So parent ID is or other type of previous class. Hope using Java. Hope using Java. Hope means object oriented programming language using Java. Okay, so in this topic we are talking about the variable. So what is variable here? So variable can play a major role activity in our programming language, either C language or C++ or program Java language or Python, whatever it may be. The variable is the most important term while writing the program. Okay, so what is variable here? Variable is identifier. It can identify the value, take the value at the time of running the program or compile the program. Okay, so variable can take some given holding some values and giving at the time of runtime values, the time of giving output. So simply we call it as a variable is identifier whose value is changed during the execution of the program is called variable. Okay, so variable is identifier, it is an identifier. It is an identifier whose value. That means this value is changed, whose value is changed during the execution of the program. So variable can take two types of the variables. So first one is the instance variable and another one is the static variable. Okay, if you are giving at the time, if you are giving a value to the variable at the time of writing program, that is called static variable. If you are giving at the time of runtime, it is the dynamic variable. Okay, dynamic initially they will not take any value. Okay, but in the program we are giving some value to the program at the time of writing a program, a is equal to 10, b is equal to 20. Okay, it is the static values. So it can hold the entire program will run many times giving same answer. Okay, so that is called static programming. Okay, static program that means static variable. Once it hold values to the a is equal to 10, the entire program or run or compile any time that value is always 10. Okay, you are giving at the time of runtime values, the value is always changed during the execution period. Okay, so what is variable here? So variable is an identifier. Variable is an identifier. Identifier means so we can identify the value. For example, here I am writing some value. So a. So this is the a. It is not a variable. Just it is a variable. When it is variable, we are declaring some data type in front of the name of the A. Okay, for example, I am writing here. So, int A here. So, this is the A variable. This is the not variable. This is the A character. This is the variable A. Okay. So, whenever we are declaring a variable, before that variable, we can specify type of the data. So here I am specifying data type. Which type it is? Integer type. Okay. Which type it is? Integer type. Okay. So A is a integer value. So A can hold which values? Integer values only, but not taking float values or double values or character values. Okay. It's taking some integer values. So A can have some values. So A can have some range. So integer contains some range, that is called minus 13,762 plus 13,768. Okay, so that is the range of the value. So minus 13,768. The total value is 65,536. Okay, but actually we are adding these two numbers. It is 5 is accepted. But positive number and before between positive number and negative numbers we are placing some value which is called zero. So hence it is called 0 plus 0. That means so we are adding 5, 8 plus 5, 7, 15, but 0 is also adding. So that means called 16. Next remaining is process same. Okay. So the integer value is minus 7768 to 32,767. So if we are giving a value to the A, A is A, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, whatever the value, because the value is 11,000 only. Okay, if we are giving value to the 40,000, okay, if not taking that value, why? Because this is the out of the bound of integer range. Okay, actually integer can hold only minus 7768 to 37,767 only. Okay, but here I am entering which value? 40,000. This is the out of bound for integer range. Okay, hence while we are using 40,000, we are using some long int. What is that? Long int. Long, you know, long. Okay, long is actually this is the integer character, sorry, integer numbers. So actually, our common types of data types. There are four types of the data types. First one is the primary data types or main data types or fundamental data types or basic data types. Second one is the user defined data type. And third one is the derived data type. And fourth one is empty data type. Okay. In these fundamental data types, we have four types of the data types. First one is the integer. Second one is the float. Third one is the double. Fourth one is character. Okay. In this, integer can also divide into four parts. That is called short int, long int, int. Okay, so these are divided into integer parts. Okay, if you are taking very low value, you are using short. Okay, you are entering long value. That means part nearly above 33,000. We are using long, and also contains signed integer values, unsigned integer values also available. Okay, so today I am talking about only integer. Tomorrow I am talking about what is the data type, what is the data type, and how it is work, and how many types of data types, what we need to develop data types. Okay, so integer. So this is called a variable. Okay, variable is also defined in front of the variable. We are specifying some data type. Okay, we are specifying some data type, either integer, float, char, double, whatever it may be. We are using the variable, we are using the data type in front of the variable. That is the variable name. Okay, here I am declaring there is no data type here, hence it is the A character only. That means simple English, simple A. Okay, here I am entering integer before the A, then A is the integer variable. Then A is the integer variable. Why? Because it can specify, the data type can specify the variable is an integer variable. So A can hold between these two numbers. Between these two numbers. Okay. So integer also some contents of data type. Integer contains some data size. So actually in C programming languages, integer can hold how many bytes? Integer size. Which size is 2 bytes, float size is 4 bytes. Do you know? Size of the integer, size of the character, size of the float. Okay? But here are also some sizes are available. But compared to in C programming, C language can take a integer value as 2 bytes, but Java can take 4 values. Okay? Integer size is in C language 2 bytes. But in Java language, integer size is 4 bytes. But also, float also 4 bytes. Okay? Same as this. but the difference is only integer value. Okay. So next one, what is a variable here? Variable is an identifier whose value is changed during the execution of the program. Okay. When we are writing the program, so enter a value. Enter a value. Next one also enter b value. Okay. At the time of running the program, we are entering some value, a and b. So here, the program is does not contain a value and b value. Okay, this is the values are given at the time of running the program. That means alt controller, control F9. Okay, in C programming language, I'm explaining. Okay, so at the time of program, so c is equal to a plus b. This is also b. So initially, we are writing a comma b comma c. Okay, A, B, C has no values. Still, at the compile the program and run the program. Okay, we are entering some values. It asking that at the time of compiler enter A value, then we are entering some value. Then B value 20. Then the C is equal to A plus B. Then C value is 30. Okay, this is the answer. While you getting answer, if you are giving A value here. I am not writing this statement. A is equal to M, B is equal to 20. Okay, C has no value. Why? Because C has formula. Okay, if A plus B is the answer of this C. Okay, so this is the answer. This program is implemented by all of us in the classroom. The result is 30. This is the static programming. Why? Because the answer is always static. Static means stable. Okay. If you are not like this, if you are doing something better than the static program, you are writing like this, write like this, int a comma b comma c, and for example printf enter a value. Next p, that means also here is also a scanner is here, but I am not writing here, so enter b value and formula is input a plus b. Okay. If you compile the program, there is no errors and run the program. At the time of running the value, and then the program is run the program, it asks what it asks, enter a value. For example, I'm entering a value is 100, b value is 200. Then the result is 300. Okay. If the same program you are doing, so enter your values. So a value is not fixed 100. Okay, this is my opinion. Next one, a value is given by your opinion while you execute the program. Okay, then the answer is always changing. Then the answer is always changing based on my opinion, based on the your opinion. Okay, so this value is changed whenever it changed at the time of run the program, at the time of the running the program. So how to run the program? R plus R. Like what they? CTRL. Control plus F9. Okay. So this is the other program. Before going that, we need to compile the program. How to compile the program? Alt plus C. Or Alt plus F9. For compile the program. Why do you compile the program? Why do you compile the program? Because the compiler tells how many wrongs are placed on in your program. Okay? If the program does not contain any errors, you are getting the result successfully. Okay? If your program contains at least one error, you should not able to see the result of the program. Is it right? Is it right or wrong? This is the right position. Okay, so the program contains no errors, the result will be displayed on the console. If your program contains some errors, you need to debug the errors. Debug means to modify the errors. Okay, until the process is going, the results and the errors are going to zero. If the errors are going to zero, the result will be displayed on the console very easily. Okay, so if the program contains any errors, the result will not be the result is not displayed on the console. If a program is containing zero errors, the result will be place at the type of the console. Okay, so before going to program, so first of all, what to do in C programming language? We are going to type the program and save the program. Next, what to do? To compare the program for checking errors, is it errors or not? Okay, if the errors are there, you need to modify. That means modifying nothing but debug the errors. Debugging the errors. Okay, then the program contains zero errors. You need to go to run the program. Run means what? Entering values. Entering values. Okay, so then the place so we are entering some values. At the time of running time, it asks enter A value and enter B value. Then the result are, when you are entering the value A, B and we are displaying the result very easily. Okay, next one, if the program is does not do compare but not do run the program. Okay, why we compile the program? To check the errors. Without check the errors, we are not able to see the output of the program. We are not able to see the output of the program. Before going to see the result, you need to save the program, you need to compare the program with the zero errors and run the program successfully and see the output very easily. Okay, so here I am declaring a variable A, B, C. So here the A has no value, B has no value, C has also no value. Okay, at the time of run the program, we are entering some values. So here I am entering 100, 200. Then what is the A value here? 100. What is the value of B here? 200. Okay, then the result is 300. It's my opinion. Okay, so suppose we are doing the program entering A value. For example, tell me your full answer. A for B for answer. Yeah. Okay. B for 20. The result is 30. So here A value needs to change. Here initially I am taking 10, 100, you are taking 10. How to say this program, these values have changed. When they changed while running the program. This is the running time. This is the running period. The results, the values have changed. That means during the execution of the program. Execution is nothing but running the program. Execution is nothing but running the program. How to run the program? Run the program Alt R, Enter or Ctrl F9. You need to press Ctrl plus F9. Then the runtime value is executed. At the time of running the program, you are entering A value and B value. Okay? So this program is always a dynamic version. Because of the value is changed as spontaneously, but not the static. Okay? So we need always a dynamic memory allocation. Here the dynamic memory allocation is placed. Okay? If you are taking A is equal to 100, B is equal to 100, the result is always 200. But not the change. Okay, this is the static programming style. Okay? So at the time of running the program, the values are changed. That is also known as running is nothing but the execution of the program. So see that identify this whose value is change during the where execution of the program. Execution is nothing but run the program. Execution is nothing but run the program. Okay? So, how to declare the A variable? How to declare single variable? How to declare multiple variables? Okay? There is a syntax available. So, if you are taking some single variable, syntax for single variable. Okay? So, syntax of single variable because this before going to the variable is visible and a type space variable name. Variable name and lastly we place the semicolon. Okay. So here I am example. This is the syntax. Syntax of a single variable. So data type, what are data type? Either int, float, char or double. Next, in Java language, there is string data type is also available. String is also available and Boolean data type is also available. Okay? So, I am writing by default. Initially, I am writing the gunlock variable is A and the gunlock data type is int. So, this is the answer. Okay? If you are declaring multiple variables, so there is a syntax for multiple variables. x but multiple variables. Multiple means so many variables. We are going to data type space variable name 1. Okay, so here I am writing variable name 1, variable name 2, variable name 3, and so on, and variable name. Okay, so this is the syntax. Let me explain. So in the example, int we have taken a comma b comma c, a comma b comma c. So this is the example. This is the syntax. So first of all, you have to place data type and the variable 1, variable 2, variable 3, and so on, bn. Okay. So here I need only three variables. That is called integer variable. Int a comma b comma c. So abc belongs to step data type. It is a data type only. Okay. So variable contains some rules. Variables contain some rules. Okay. So how to declare the variables? How to declare the variables? We are declaring the variables. We have to follow some rules. We have to follow some rules. Okay, so we have so int a, int a 77, int 27, int okay, so there is a chance of declaring variables. I am entering values into a, into a 777, into 777 semicolon, into 777 a semicolon, into 7 a 7. Okay. Here I am declaring some variables. So in this variables we have how many declaring variables? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So variable name is AA, variable name is A777, variable name is 777, variable name is 777A, variable name is 7A7. Okay? So there is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 statements. So in this some statements are wrong, some statements are right. Okay? Please correct them. So is this first sentence, is it right or wrong? Is it right or wrong? Is it right? Yeah, I'm already using that. Okay. Secondly, A 777, is it right or wrong? Wrong? Okay, wrong. In 777, right or wrong?
Right.
Okay, into 777A. Into 7A7.
Wrong.
Okay. So actually, I'm telling. So this is the right statement, correct statement. This is also right statement. This is also wrong statement. This is also wrong statement. This is also wrong statement. Okay.
Why? Because when you are declaring a variables, we need to follow some rules. We need to follow some rules. Okay. What rules are there? Okay. Before going to that, we need to see what is data type and what is variable. Okay, so this is the declaration of the variable. I will tell you what rules are going to follow the rules when you declare the variables. Okay, in the coming session. Okay, thank you.